Matthews, when he was born at about 3 months, the doctor said he wouldn't be able to walk, and he had accomplished that goal when he was 3 years old. He started walking with a walker. After several months of physical therapy, he started walking. His dad died when he was 12 years old, and he had to work through that. He got through that. When he was in elementary school, we used to watch wrestling. He watched wrestling with his dad growing up. He talked about doing wrestling, being on a wrestling team since he wasn't able to play football. And he wanted to be on a wrestling team. And when we moved to Dodge, back to Georgia, and he started school at Dodge County High School, they did not have a wrestling team. And he started a petition to get a wrestling team started, and it went from there. A wrestling team was started that he was a part of, and that made us very proud of him. And he has become a mature, responsible gentleman, very compassionate, friendly. I am really extremely proud of him. No matter what, I ain't never gave up.
Matt who? Oh, Mad Dog, or Maddie. He's known by a lot of things, but yeah, I've had the pleasure of knowing Matt for probably the last 15 years. Matt came to me a couple of years back, maybe 3 years ago now, just to see how far he could push his physical limits and wanted to do CrossFit. Knowing that there would be some limitations and things that he wouldn't be able to do, but it's been really cool to see Matt's journey through these 3 years and see how hard he works and how far he's been able to push himself.
Special in his own unique way, even though, you know, he's struggled with the things that have held him back as far as his disability or anything else, he always pushes through it. He perseveres. He proves to everyone that he truly is special and that he can do anything that he puts his mind to.
Well, how would you describe Matt to someone who hasn't met him before?
Sure. Just kidding. Really a stand-up guy. Someone that is going to be there for you however he needs to be.
You know, those ties that he had been going for in May, and the progress he had made, but also the, you know, problems that he had come up with him, you know, being turned down for fights, for him not getting cleared by the doctor to fight. And then after that, seeing him, you know, train himself through constantly working out, and then working toward going to tournaments and matches, and working it when, you know, fighting's hard now. And I've seen him really push himself to keep, you know, doing more of that and get to where he wants to be.
Consider his disability, like he should be able to do half of what he's doing. But he is. And the fact that he's going and he's wanting to do, you know, jiu-jitsu and wrestling, I mean, that is incredible. That's a miraculous feat.
Be right in the field, Justin. Ma'am, a tornado just came and tore down your whole city. What are you gonna do? We gonna f***ing rebuild! That boy here, I'm gonna die here!
I always knew Matt from football because he would be on the sidelines and he always had his walking sticks, but I knew he was always struggling. And even at a young age, I could see the drive in his eyes. He's always had that from the very start.
What have you seen him try to accomplish?
So I've seen him try to work his way into as many fights as he can, which is difficult for him.
The main thing that I've seen is his improvement in balance and also mobility. Houston, he would run a 200-meter run, jog it, and he may fall 5-6 times. Now I can see him run a 200 and not fall at all, or fall one time. One of the strongest people that I mentally that I've ever met.
You show me that it is necessary in, you know, in life to be persistent and determined no matter what. Sometimes we have to tell, sometimes it's like, oh, that doesn't seem like, you know, something that's gonna work, but that's, you know, that's just how Matt, you know, operates. He's, you know, he stays creative, he has to stay, he tries to stay innovative on to get to where he wants to be, because he knows that he's gonna have a something come up given, you know, his limitations, but he's persistent and determined. He's gonna find a way around that, and that's how you operate in life.
He has mastered life without the crutches. He has had fights. He's been in the gym kicking ass. He even helped train me in some jujitsu.
Go on for some time about the different accomplishments that he's made in the gym with us, but you know, pull-ups, push-ups, you know, all those kind of things that you know, that you think would slow him down, doesn't seem to slow him down much at all. Matt seems to find a way to make things happen that he wants to do. Matt's been an inspiration to us all to see how he pushes the physical body. We all push it, but we don't all have the limitations that Matt has, and those limitations are just that to some people. To Matt, they're not really limitations, they're just hurdles, and he's going to jump them. And it's great to see that. It's very encouraging, it's very motivating to the rest of the group, our community here, Forward Lean. And you know, I've seen him work hard. I've seen him work hard for his goals. And Matt's always a team player. He's always pushing everybody around him. And everybody loves to see Matt work hard in here. So Matt's been a great addition to our community. And it's been a pleasure and a blessing to me to be a part of this journey.
If anybody was to describe him, it would be as an ambitious, hustling, hardworking, badass person and friend.
Anything he does, want to be there for him, and he thinks the same way. He's just one of my best friends. I don't know what more I can say than that.
A lot is rap, but we are not the same. It's bigger than the money, ain't about the fame. I could be anything that I wanna be. I put my name on the line for the legacy. A lot of us rap, but we are not the same. It's bigger than the money, ain't about the fame. I could be anything that I wanna be. I put my name on the line for the legacy. I put my name on the line for the legacy. I'm the type to shoot the sheriff and the deputy. Rest in peace to Bob Marley, I'm a Rastafari. Meditating off the ganja got me feeling Gandhi. The way I'm killing Lee, I could catch a homie. I'm just trying to be a goat and only I can stop me. A lot of rappers like sheep, they see the wave and copy. Surfing as niggas wanna be Johnny Tsunami. They either love me for me or don't love me at all. I could never sell my soul and perpetrate the fraud. I ain't even choose to rap, I was chose by God. This was back in 2010 at the Kroger's job. I was praying for my purpose, I was feeling worthless. Asking why I'm really here, hoping that it surfaced. One day I got the prophecy that I'm a prophet. So no weapon formed against me can stop. Haters stop. A lot of niggas rap, but we are not.